How to regain your power. This is something that most people don't think about, but we lose power every time we are afraid, every time we are unclear, and every time that we do something that is wrong to ourselves or to others. Our life is extremely complicated in the system that we live, and we often make decisions based on our fears and not on what we want, because often we do not know what we want. So, to regain your power, first of all, you need to accept that you are you and not the expectations of others. The expectations of others are contracts in which you enter most of the time by default, because you feel pressurized, because somebody is upset with you, because somebody says you don't love them, and you feel cornered. That is not a good way of making a contract. When you have an interaction with a person, you have to sit down calmly with the other person when you are both in a good mood and deal with the stuff in the same way you will deal with a working contract when you get, you know, a job from a company and you decide what is it that you are going to do and what is it that you are not going to do and how much you are going to be paid, etc. Living with other people, having other people in your life requires the same precision. You need to be clear about what others expect from you, and you need to agree that their expectations are reasonable and you are prepared to fulfill them. If you don't want to fulfill them, if you are feeling pressurized by others to do what they are expecting, this is a moment in which you need to stop and take a break. And you know, if you feel the other person is overpowering you, and this is not a business thing, you might want to let go of those relationships. If those relationships are family, you need to take a break and come back another day when everybody is calm, or just go out for a walk and get your mind clear what you are prepared to do and what you are not prepared to do. And once you have decided what to do, you need to be firm. Empowerment starts by loving yourself, or accepting yourself as you are, because you know, love is a not here, not there word. Self-acceptance as you are is the first step of empowerment. The second is knowing what you want from life. You can change these things at any time. And be clear with your relationships at all levels, what you are prepared to do and what you are not prepared to do. And stick to it. Because if you don't stick to it, the emotional blackmail will always keep you out of balance and deplete your energy. When your emotional body is depleted, you are less able to attract to yourself what you need. You need a lot of emotional energy to create your life, to attract whatever it is that you want to have in your life. So I leave you with these pointers. Think about things and empower yourself.